Let's start off first here with a 1991 Lincoln Scent that has been broad struck and it's got a brockage. All right, so this is really cool. This coin only sold for around $30. However, it sold for quite many years ago. So I believe in today's market, it would sell for much more than 30 bucks. Now moving on to a 1991 broad struck coin. Now this coin here only sold for around 16 bucks, which is kind of surprising. I think it's definitely worth 16 bucks. I would take it for 16 bucks to add to my collection. So always be on the lookout for those, not just on pennies, but all kinds of different coinage. That's what a broad strike looks like. All right, now here is a 1991 D mint mark. Now this is solely valuable because it has the high grade of a mint state 68 red. So you know, even at a 67, it could not be so valuable. You could have a big gap in prices there. Now this coin here sold for around $440. So keep that in mind, the very, very high grade is what gives it all of that value. So mint state 68, 69, and 70 probably for the 1991 D is the coins that you want that are going to have, you know, the real value. Now here is a 1991 D that has been struck off center. Again, you can look for off centers on all kinds of different coins. I talk about that in many of my coin videos here on the channel. This coin sold for around 20 bucks. Same thing here, we have a coin that was struck off center. It is the D mint mark from 1991 and it was struck 70% off center. Now this penny here sold for around $50. So they're all gonna sell for different prices. You know, in 1991, they produced over 4.1 billion of the D mint mark. So they're not valuable or rare in terms of how many they actually made, but something like this, a 1991 no mint mark that has that mint state 68 plus grade with the red, this coin is gonna be, you know, super, super expensive. This penny sold for over $1,100. $1,100 for that penny. It's gonna be super, super difficult to get a grade like this. Now here's a 1991 no mint mark that is a mated pair. So this is a lot of two coins. They are graded by NGC at a mint state 65 red. Well, at least this coin here is. We'll see what the next one's graded at. And they are mated together. So here's the front of one coin. And then here's the back of that coin. However, this coin was mated with this coin. Now this coin is graded at mint state 65 red as well. So we see that there how those two connect together. That's a mated pair. And again, that's not just on the Lincoln Scent, it could be on different coinage as well, different denominations of coins. This coin here sold for over $180. Now here's a 1991 that was struck 35% off center. This penny here sold for around $50. So you can get off center coins fairly cheap on eBay, but something like this, it's graded at a mint state 66 red, off center 1991, 50 bucks. You know, probably didn't make back what they paid to get it graded, but hey, it's 50 bucks. Now here's a 1991, again, 35% off center. This coin here sold for around $45. Here is the 1991 that was overstruck on a 1991 Roosevelt dime. So that is a double denomination. You see the outline of Roosevelt's head there. We have a Lincoln cent struck on a Roosevelt dime. This coin here sold for around $2,200. So over a $2,000 coin. Can't beat that. And in 1991, you know, the no mint mark, they produced over 5.1 billion of those coins. So again, they're not valuable in terms of how many they actually made. Now they also have the proof coin in 1991, and that's what we're looking at here. This is the 1991 S. And it's graded at a proof 70 red, so a perfect grade, deep cameo. This coin sold for over $660. Now here's the 1991 that has the obverse and the reverse struck through, and we see that how it's fading out around the rim of the coin on both sides of the penny. This penny sold on eBay for around $33. So, you know, not really valuable there, but 30 bucks. Now the 1922 penny is a very unique coin because in 1922 they only produced the D mint mark, the 1922 Denver mint, and they only produced around 7 million of those coins. So here is an actual thing that we're going to look for here. So we got the 1922D, that is the regular. You have the D mint mark, and then we got the 1922 plain, and then we got the 1922 weak D, and then we got the 1922 no D weak reverse, and then we got the 1922 no D strong reverse. All right, so I know, very, very complicated, right? All right, so first let's start with an error coin here. This is a 1922D wheat penny that has a reverse die crack. So we can see that here on both sides of the coin, really on three different parts of the coin. So we see that one going through the O and one. We see the other here on the left side of the coin going through the wheat stock, and then one going through the top of the other wheat stock here on the right side of the penny. So because of that, this coin sold for over $200. Now first, here is a regular 1922D. Now, you know, it says $10, but depending on the grade, of course, that value can fluctuate. So this is what it's gonna look like. You see the D mint mark under the date 1922. Now this here is a 1922D that has an extremely, extremely high grade for this coin. Now it's graded at a mint state 66, and it's graded at a red. So if you're not familiar with red pennies versus brown pennies, definitely watch my video. I've done a whole video explaining that, so check that out on my channel. Now this coin here is an expensive penny. Now this wheat penny sold for over $19,000 because of its high grade. So there are not many out there that exist in 1922 with this grade. Now, here is a 1922 weak reverse and a no D mint mark, which it is supposed to have the D mint mark. So we can see here the 1922 underneath the date, no mint mark there. And you know, it's graded at a mint state 64 red. And then we see the weak reverse. So you see how the design is like weak? You know, I guess that's the best way to explain it. It's not a strong reverse like the one we're gonna look at next. So this coin here sold for over $22,000. So always watch out for these 1922 wheat pennies. Now this is a 1922 penny, no D. Now this coin here sold on eBay. You see that it has not been graded. I definitely would have had it graded. It's gonna be a brown penny, but you see here on the reverse, it's got a strong reverse. Very strong reverse. You can see the whole design very clear and crisp. Now, this coin here sold for over $1,200 as is on eBay. Now, if we look at another 1922, now this is a very, very super valuable coin. This is a 1922, again, with the strong reverse, the no D mint mark underneath the date, strong reverse like crazy, and this coin sold for over $80,000. $80,000. Now here's a 1922. You can see that it is not in the best shape. It's very, very worn down, and it doesn't have the D mint mark. But because it's a 1922D, this coin sold for over $340. So it's graded at about good 3, so really, really low grade on this coin. Here's just another example of the 1922 with the missing D and the strong reverse. Now here's a 1922. Now this is to show you a different type of grade. This is graded at about uncirculated 58, and it does have the strong reverse, again, missing that D mint mark. So you can see that there on the front, and then here on the reverse, you see that strong reverse. Now this penny here sold for over $7,000. And like I said, the grade is about uncirculated 58. Now here's an example of a 1922 weak D. So you can see how the D mint mark is, you know, not really all there. It's, you know, that's why it's called the weak D mint mark. So always be on the lookout for that. Here's another example of a weak D. You can barely make out that D mint mark there. So always, always be on the lookout for the 1922 wheat penny. All right, guys, don't forget to subscribe in the middle. Check out the videos to the left of me. And until tomorrow, I'll see you on the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.